Welcome back, my name is Lasno Meal, and today we're going to talk about Cyberpunk Red and Cyberpunk 2077. In the most recent interview on Dicebreaker, Mike Pondsmith, one of the co-creators of Cyberpunk 2020, opens up about the development of Cyberpunk Red and the plans for the future of the story. There were many notable things to talk about here, first one being the inspiration around the creation of the Cyberpunk universe, well, his vision of that universe, and many people assumed it was inspired by William Gibson's Neuromancer, but I can't describe how many times people in the comments said that, but actually he was more inspired by the film Blade Runner and a novel from John Williams called Hardwired that I recommend everyone to read. I mean, John Williams also helped playtest this game when it was coming out. And this is what Mike has to say about it. Most cyberpunk, including my much beloved Blade Runner, is pretty depressing because of the one of the elements of it is that the people involved are not heroes. Cyberpunks don't save the world, they save themselves. If saving the world comes out of that, then that's great. Then he looks back at Cyber Generation, which was a supplement for Cyberpunk 2020, and later in 2005 they released Cyberpunk V3, which wasn't really accepted in the community because a lot of people assumed that it deviated from what Cyberpunk was about. Cyberpunk V3 focused more about the elements of transhumanism like full-body cyborgs and humans with their minds downloaded into robots. And because it had some elements of science fiction, people really did not like it, and this is what Mike Pondsmith had to say about it. What I learned when we did the ill-fated Cyberpunk V3 is that the whole idea of cyberpunk really does involve lighted jackets and flying cars. I thought at the time that was where cyberpunk was going, but the genre kind of shifted and stayed in the 80s. When you start moving into the elements that make up transhumanism, there's no exact period of time for that, but it definitely isn't in the 80s, and so the feeling definitely changed. So when people talk about cyberpunk in general, one thing usually comes to our mind. It's where high tech meets low life, and generally cyberpunk was always about the common people, the people who live their lives now in a different way because technology became so cheap and advanced, but the world is so screwed up that a lot of things didn't go into that sci-fi universe but rather stay on the ground in a sense and just shows our world as it is, which is gritty and dangerous. And because the world of cyberpunk is screwed up, I mean, both the government is failing, it doesn't care about its people, corporations are taking everything for themselves, and basically everything else that stays on the street is where the cyberpunk story begins. But again, the whole world of cyberpunk is about that, about corporations being, you know, exploiting the common people, etc, etc. They also refer to the part where putting way too much tech in yourself makes you lose humanity. It's a very nice concept, actually. That's when you can go cyber psycho and, you know, you get shut down by Max Stack, the elite police force in Night City. Just that element in the game shows how much the overuse of technology can impact you, but hey, the world is all about going over the top, so go for it. Then Mike talks more about Gen Con and Jumpstart Kit, especially how many people wanted to buy it, and because, you know, CD Projekt Red announced they're working on Cyberpunk 2077 back in 2013, so it brought a lot of people who never played the tabletop RPGs. They actually got more interested in that, and I'm honestly glad that Artal Sorian is making these many sales, because going into the tabletop RPG, reading through the world book, reading through the rule book, is definitely going to bring you closer to Cyberpunk 2077, and it will kinda prepare you for what you can expect, and you will learn more about the lore and the story. And they had to move boxes and boxes just to satisfy the need, which is honestly insane, but I think that 2020 is the perfect time to revive the genre and definitely revive that brand of cyberpunk. Because the world we live in is already cyberpunk itself, so when you have games and books that supplement that, that can only bring you positive things in the future. They also admit they were extremely burned out after releasing the Jumpstart kit, and honestly, yes, that can actually get to you, especially because you're working on Cyberpunk Red, which is going to be a huge world book, and then you also had to release the Jumpstart kit. The lag to doing the full game came out partially because doing the Jumpstart kit almost killed us. It was just insane doing it. Even more importantly, we wanted to make sure that the stuff in 2077 and stuff we developed in Red meshed, and there were things that hadn't been decided yet in 2077, because keep in mind, writing about this world, creating this world, you have to do a lot of research, you have to really think about a lot of things, so I do understand why it became so exhausting. So yes, Cyberpunk Red does come out sometimes during the year. They do have some release windows, but nothing confirmed so far. We'll keep you updated when they decide to release, actually. I would expect it before Cyberpunk 2077 comes out, but we shall see. Hopefully everything goes according to the plan. And because the world of Cyberpunk is so vast, Mike did say that they are apparently working on two new expansions for Cyberpunk Red. Taking Cyberpunk Red into the 2077 timeline is already in the planning stages, but Pondsmith says it will be something that's released further down the line. For the end, he said this: "Sooner or later, we're going to have to cover some of this stuff. There's a lot of amazingly cool things that we've got coming up that just really need to be said. They need to be put out there for people to look at and go, I didn't see that coming." So definitely great news for the fans out there. Keep in mind, life does go on after 2077, and it will be interesting to see what CDPR and Artal Saurian have for us in the future, especially for the future of this universe. The video game is definitely going to bring people closer to the tabletop RPG, and maybe someone goes out to play it for the first time, which is great. But this is everything I have for today. I left a link to this article down below. I definitely recommend going through it. And that's it. Smash that like and subscribe button for more. And also tell me down below, are you excited about Cyberpunk 2077 and Cyberpunk Red? Also join our growing community on Twitter and Discord. This is LKM signing out, and stay classy, everyone. Bye-bye.